Jackie Brenda, and this is Yappy Hour with Jackie. And today we have Dr. Micheal Breus on with us. He is the sleep doctor. Hi, Micheal. How are you today?
I'm great, Jackie. Thanks for having me on your show. This is the most unique show I think I have done.
Well, great. We love to hear that. So, you know, here on our Yappy Hour, we like to have a little drink and something that we can do with our dogs. So, Micheal, there, you've got a beer with you today.
I got a beer.
A little Blue Moon. Absolutely. And so the featured drink that I'm doing for the show, since Dr. Breus is the sleep doctor, I'm doing a de-stress hot toddy.
So that's perfect.
Is a chamomile tea, and yep. I put just a little bit. If you'd like to add a little cocktail to it, a little alcohol to it, you can do gin or vodka a little bit, and some honey, and make a little hot toddy.
I love it.
And so for the pup drink, I did a relaxing pup toddy. So that is a little bit of chamomile tea and bone broth. Or you can use anything you have, chicken broth, any type of broth that you have will work.
It's a pup toddy.
Let's introduce the dogs. Tell me your dogs' names.
So this is Sparky. Oh my gosh, look at your guy.
We've got Sparky the Chihuahua.
Yeah, so this is Sparky. Well, we think he's a Chihuahua. He's a lot of something. Certainly Chihuahua's in there somewhere. And then this is Hugo. Come here, sugar. Ugh. This is my buddy, Sugar Bear.
Oh, Hugo the Sugar Bear. Look at him. He's so cute. Thanks for being on with us today, Sparky and Hugo Sugar Bear. So this is Penny.
Hi, Penny.
Say hi.
She's cute.
Oh, thank you. Thank you for the kisses. And let's see. So I've got Miss Penny's little drink. What do you
think? You going to try the hot toddy?
Huh? You want to try it? No, not right now. Okay. We'll try it a little later.
Fair enough.
Yeah. All right. Well, let's get into it. So let's talk a little bit about sleep and tell me what my audience who might be a little bit stressed or anxious during this time, maybe they're dealing with some sleep depression, getting enough sleep right now. Yeah. What are your suggestions for them?
So first of all, it's 100% normal to not be sleeping well right now. So I don't want anybody to think, oh my gosh, there's something wrong with me. I've had this weird reaction. Nobody is sleeping well at all, just to be super duper clear. Also for people to know, I've put all of this information on a website for you. So there's a website that you can go to. You can download it all. So don't worry about taking too many notes. We just want you to listen for now. It's all written down for you at a website. So don't worry about that part. So here's the bottom line is we know that sleep is not only the most least expensive, but the most effective way to improve your immune function. And many people don't really think about sleep when it comes to immune function, but there's a couple of things, if you remember way back to high school biology, that can be pretty helpful here. So number one, there were these things called killer T cells. These were, if you remember way back when, these are white blood cells that actually fight infection, and they fight viral infection in particular. Here's the interesting thing is killer T cell production increases with better quality sleep. So when you have high quality sleep, it actually improves that immune function right out of the gates. Part number two, which is also quite interesting, is if you look at, there was a great study at the University of San Francisco, and what they discovered was if somebody wasn't sleeping well, they gave them the flu shot and then they exposed them to the flu, 70% of people got the flu. However, if they did sleep well, then got the flu shot and then were exposed to flu, I think it was less than 10% of people got the flu. So when the inoculation comes out, we all want to have a great night's sleep before so that we can make sure that it's effective for us in the future. So there's a lot of science behind sleep and immune function, but let's get to the practical stuff, okay? So what should you do in order to sleep better right now? So my very first recommendation is keep a consistent sleep schedule. What do I mean by that? Your wake-up time. I don't actually care what time you go to bed, but you've got to make your wake-up time super duper consistent. Why? Because that way your circadian rhythm, which is that internal biological clock, knows what to do. Lots and lots of people are saying, heck with it, I don't have a commute right now. I'm going to stay up and watch movies and I'm going to sleep late. That's just not a good idea. If you want to stay up a little bit later than normal, I don't think I have a problem with it, but get up at a consistent time, including the weekends, okay? Because you do not catch up on sleep on the weekends. The more consistent your schedule is, the better. Also, if you can, avoid napping. A lot of people are saying, I'm going from Zoom call to Zoom call, my eyes hurt, my bedroom's right in there, I'm just going to chill out and go take a nap. Terrible idea. It lowers sleep drive, which is the thing that makes you fall asleep at night. And so when you take a nap during the day, it makes it very difficult to fall asleep at night. Anybody with insomnia should never, ever nap. So first two things is consistent wake-up time, 7 days a week, no napping. Those are the first two. The second two have to do with something that's been interesting that's been occurring, which is an increase in alcohol consumption and an increase in caffeine. Now, we're obviously having a little alcohol and enjoying ourselves now, but what's the right way to do this during COVID? To be clear, alcohol decreases immune function, period. It doesn't matter how much you drink, it absolutely decreases immune function. But hey, we want to be able to have a beer. I like red wine or scotch. How are we going to be able to manage this? So it takes the average human body 1 hour to digest one alcoholic beverage. So if you have one alcoholic beverage, drink one glass of water, wait 1 hour before bed. If you have two alcoholic beverages, two glasses of water, wait 2 hours before bed. That's kind of where you have to stop, and I'll tell you why. For humans, what's interesting is once you go above two alcoholic beverages, like two full drinks, alcohol doesn't have a sedative property. It actually has an excitatory property. People get more energy when they've had their third or fourth alcoholic beverage, which number one is something that we don't want to have more energy of right before bed. But number two, with men, we find that they can get aggressive, right? And so think about it like this for a second. You've been cooped up in your house for 8 weeks. Getting hammered at night is not a good idea, okay? Also, when we think about alcohol in particular, it has a direct effect on those killer T cells we were just talking about. It actually lowers stage 3-4 sleep, which is where we get all of that great immune function. So to be fair, we don't want to have much alcohol at all if we can possibly avoid it. The second substance that we've seen a huge rise in has been caffeine. Why? Well, because people are feeling fatigued. I mean, they're sitting around, they're not moving, they feel like they've got to have more energy. So what are they doing? They're downing the caffeine. To be clear, I would argue that we are under probably the most anxiety-provoking time of almost anybody's life. I mean, let's face it. When was the last time you had anything to do with anything like this? Probably never. Right?
Well, the whole world. This is a different time for everybody.
Exactly. And so with a different time for everybody like that, I would argue that we've got a lot of anxiety. I can't think of a worse thing to do than to pour a stimulant on top of anxiety, right? Like nobody needs to be drinking any caffeine right now because we're already all amped up because we're so freaked out. There's no reason to add any more caffeine to the mix. Do yourself a favor. If you can, stop caffeine by 2 p.m. Why? It takes the average human body 6 to 8 hours to eliminate half of your caffeine. So if you stop at 2, then by 10, at least half of it's out of the system, should make it a little bit easier to fall asleep. A couple other things to give people. At the website, which we'll put below, I've got a free downloadable muscle relaxation exercise that everybody can do. I do this before bed. It's super duper helpful. I think Penny would like it as well. And then I'm telling people that they need to do a media diet 90 minutes before bed. You really don't need to know how many people died of COVID in your town right before you're falling asleep. It just doesn't make a whole lot of sense, right? So give yourself happy, positive thoughts before bed. And I'm not just saying this because I think it's a good idea. There's real science behind it. There's now data to show that optimism before bed, so feeling optimistic or happy about things, not only helps you fall asleep more quickly, but it gives you more positive dreams, which is pretty awesome, right? Because right now everybody's experiencing quarantine dreaming, right? Which is this weird stress-related dream or nightmare or vividness to the dreams that has a big effect right now. So this is a product of being overstressed. Again, not something we can help because there's so much of that going on. But doing something positive before bed can be good. So number one, give yourself a media diet 90 minutes before bed. Number two, consider a hot bath. It turns out that a nice hot bath about 90 minutes before bed increases your core body temperature, which is good because when you get out, It lowers, which is a signal to your brain to release melatonin. So believe it or not, a hot bath before bed works really well. But here's the secret tip. You want it to be a bubble bath. Why on earth would you want it to be a bubble bath? Because the bubbles form a layer of insulation that goes across the top of the water. It makes the water stay hotter longer, which helps that core body temperature increase. So Mr. Bubble is definitely your friend 90 minutes before bed. Throw in a little lavender to get a little bit of that aromatherapy, which could be good. Throw in your bed partner, maybe have a little intimacy or a little time together. Again, relaxing, doing something fun before bed is going to be certainly positive for you as well. The other thing I like to ask people to do is form a gratitude list. So while you're lying in bed, think about all the things that you're actually grateful for, whether it's your home, food, family, health, whatever it is. And I can appreciate the fact that there are going to be times right now where you might not be grateful for a whole lot, right? I mean, at the end of the day, you should be able to find several things that you're grateful for. And remember, optimism promotes healthy, good sleep. So this could be a good, fun thing to do. If you're having a hard time figuring out a gratitude list, one of my favorite things to do is to pull out an old photo album from years ago and just open it up to a random page. Number one, it's like instant happiness because so many people are in our photo albums in our lives that we haven't thought about in such a long period of time. But again, it leads to this level of optimism before bed. Then my final recommendation, again, these are all going to be on the website, is really do a good job of cleaning up your bedroom. I'm not suggesting that anybody out there isn't clean. We're washing our sheets at least twice a week in super hot water because we had concerns about COVID being on materials. And if you don't take a shower or bath every day, it can be in your hair, things like that. And we have animals, right? Well, guess what? Our animals sleep in our bed. Yes, I am the sleep doctor. And yes, my boys are in the bed with us. By the way, also, we also have a cat.
The doggies sleep with the sleep doctor.
Every single night, doggies sleep with the sleep doctor, specifically Sparky. He sleeps on a pillow literally right next to my head. Right, buddy?
Well, that was going to be my question for you, Dr. Yeah. Breus, is do you recommend people sleeping with their dogs?
So it's really interesting. So dogs and cats are actually a little bit different. So when I met my wife, she had two cats, and they're difficult because cats are such nocturnal creatures. They might sleep all day, but they could be up all night. And sometimes they can actually be pretty disruptive. Most dogs are not that disruptive. Sugar Bear, hey, Hugo, come here, buddy. Come over. Sugar Bear can be disruptive because bulldogs snore. And Sugar Bear is one of the biggest snorers that I know. So what do you have to do?
Well, Boston Terriers, they snore a lot as well.
Yes, they do. Those little flat smushy faces.
Uh-huh. We snore, don't we, Penny? Yes.
So what do? We can use earplugs. That can be helpful. If you're going to get earplugs, be sure to make sure that they are noise level rated at 32 or below. The reasoning for this is if it's above 32, you cannot hear the smoke alarm. And clearly we want to be able to do that, right? If your dog is snoring like a freight train, like Hugo over there, you can also use a sound machine. Sound machines to mask that sound. So what do? We sleep with the television on. Yes, I'm the only sleep doctor in the universe that says it's okay to fall asleep with the TV on. To be fair, most people don't really watch it. They're distracted by it. And it just is something to listen to. 99% of televisions have got a timer built into the software. Set the timer for 3 hours, close your eyes, listen to the TV, fall asleep, you'll be fine.
Well, very nice. And we find that as well. We've always slept with our dogs. They are snorers. But apparently, my husband, and he says I am as well. So I guess we just all have to deal with each other snoring. Right, Penny?
Exactly. Yeah.
Well, good. Well, thank you so much for being on the show today, Dr. Breus. I have learned a lot and, just some really, it sounds like some easy things that maybe people just don't quite think about. But they all make sense. So getting that sleep is going to build my immune system. That makes me feel better about right now in Arizona. A lot of people are thinking about going back to work and reopening places. So, the better our immunity is, the better we can, if we are exposed, fight it off, I assume.
Absolutely. And also on the website, which is www.thesleepdoctor.com/sleep-pandemic. I also give recommendations to what do you do if you actually contract COVID-19. COVID, because the sleep recommendations would be different. You actually need a lot more sleep if you're trying to fight off this disease. And in addition, I've also left three different stress reduction techniques for people to be able to utilize during this stressful time. And one of them is a free downloadable audio file so they can learn progressive muscle relaxation. So it's all free. Enjoy it, learn from it, and I promise you, you'll sleep better.
Well, thank you so much, and cheers.
Absolutely.
Cheers to the sleep doctor and us all getting some better sleep. Thanks so much for being on our show today and for including your dogs.
Thank you, guys. And this is Dr. Micheal Breus, the sleep doctor, wishing you sweet doggy dreams.
And I'm Jackie Brenda from Yappy Hour and Smelly Dog. Thanks for tuning in with us today. I hope everybody can take this advice and have a little bit of less stress and also get some better sleep and help boost your immunity. Everybody, if you can, stay home. Everyone, stay healthy, enjoy your family, and enjoy your pets.